यस, मल्टी वाइब्रेटर्स। मल्टी वाइब्रेटर इज अ रिलैक्सेशन और नॉन साइनसॉइडल ऑसिलेटर विच ऑसिलेट्स बिटवीन टू स्टेट्स, एंड इट इज अ टू स्टेज एम्पलीफायर और ऑसिलेटर ऑपरेटिंग ओनली इन टू मोड्स और स्टेट्स। सो देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ मल्टी वाइब्रेटर्स। वन इज ए स्टेबल मल्टी वाइब्रेटर, सेकेंड इज मोनो स्टेबल, एंड थर्ड इज बाई स्टेबल। So, a stable multivibrator without any trigger pulse or input, the a stable multivibrator gives an sinusoidal output which keeps on changing its state from one to another. In monostable vibrator, when one trigger pulse is given, then there is an change in state from stable to unstable state, and it comes back on its own to stable state. In bistable multi vibrator, there is a requirement of two trigger pulses. The first trigger pulse makes it to unstable state, and it keeps on continuing till the second trigger pulse is applied. Astable multi vibrator. The operation principle is that VCC is applied here, and you see, let's consider C1 is equal to C2, and R1 is equal to R4, R2 is equal to R3. They are low and these two are high. So when let's consider that initially Q1 is off and Q2 is on. So when there is an when Q2 is on, the voltage actually passes on. I mean, the current passes on this side, and here there is no current passage, due to which the voltage accumulates here, and C1 stop. There is an dip in C2 capacitor. When due to C1 is having full charge, making it negative, lesser than point minus 0.7 volts. Let's consider this as silicon. So when it is lesser than 0.7 volts, there is a sudden dip in C1, and then it starts increasing as it goes on. And then C2 is having a stable charge when, because output is becoming zero. So then you can see there is an oscillating state here in a stable multivibrator output. And then monostable multivibrator, it is also called as a single swing multivibrator or single shot multivibrator and delay multivibrator and univibrator multivibrator. So the characteristics, it has only one stable state, one transistor is on and the other is off. That is the only stable state, and external trigger pulse can change the stable state. The external trigger pulse over here can change the stable state. After some time, the circuit will switch back to its original stable state until other pulse is applied. You can see that after some time it goes off on its own. Working principle is that initially Q1 is off due to VBB negative, and Q2 is on state. VCC voltage pass through R2 and to the base of Q and Q2, and Q2 is a forward bias to conduct. This stage will not apply until any trigger pulse is applied. When trigger pulse is applied, then suddenly at Q1 position, the voltage difference, base voltage goes less than 0.7, and then this starts conducting. When this starts conducting, there is a dip here, and the Q2 will go off, which will give rise to a output which is having a higher state. So this is the working principle, and it goes off on its own when the Q1 is fully charged once again. Bistable multi vibrator. Here, mostly the working principle of any of the multi vibrators won't be asked in form of exam, but the circuit diagram as well as the output diagram sign are very important. So bistable multivibrator is also called as Jordan multivibrator and flip-flop multivibrator. And characteristics is that it has both stable state. It will remain stable until a trigger pulse causes it to switch to another state. The output can be taken from any one transistor also. So here you can see that when one trigger pulse is given here, the output changes, and when the other trigger pulse at input 2 is given, then again the output changes to the opposite side. This can be also given in a single position, like only in C4 itself there can be given trigger pulses of opposite directions. Like here you can see that one is in positive direction and other is in negative direction. So this is also possible. And that's about the multivibrators. Thank you.